In this module, we will study the last part of our chapter, first chapter, real numbers. And the last part is of decimal expansions. We have learned the first three parts, which were those EDL, FTA, and then proving of irrational numbers. And now the fourth part is decimal expansions of real numbers. Now what you can see on the screen right now, children, is that you know that very well, real numbers are of two types, rational and irrational. First thing, we will learn about the irrational numbers. You know that irrational numbers are neither terminating nor recurring. Very important. So irrational numbers, you already know the definition. You already know which numbers were the irrational numbers. Basically, we are going to think about the rational numbers, because our rational numbers are of two important types, terminating and recurring. Either the decimal expansion terminates or it recurs. We will see which examples terminate, which examples recur. So what you can see here, I have written here all the examples of terminating rational numbers. If you find out their answers, they will definitely terminate. And now, we have solved this last year. Let me recall. What was the property? You see, this denominator was, what is 2? 2 means 2 raised to 1. 4 was 2 square. 2 cube was 8. Or 2 raised to 4 was 16. Or, in these cases, see, numerator purposely I have taken 11. Why? I will tell you, explain it to you, but first let me speak about the denominators. The denominators were 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3 and 2 raised to 4. Or denominators like 5 raised to 1, 5 square was 25, 5 cube was 125, 5 raised to 4 was 625 and so on. These kind of denominators means if I want to write a general term for this, the denominator is of which form? 2 raised to m. Numerator will speak later on. But the denominator must be of the form 2 raised to m, the expansion will terminate. Or the denominator, some 5 power of 5, means denominator is some power of 5, 5 raised to n. That is another case of the denominator, correct? Either 2 raised to m or 5 raised to n, or which other are terminating? See, what is this 10? 2 into 5 is 10. What is 20? 2 2's are 4, 4 5's are 2 2's are means what? 2 square into 5. What is 40? 2 cube into 5. What is 50? 2 into 2. So this 50 was what? 2 into 5 square. See, yeah, this 2 square and 5, 2 cube and 5, or 2 and 5 square, combination of 2s and 5s is allowed. On the contrary, if I had 11 upon 30, now what is 30? 2 into 3 into 5, this extra 3, this will not terminate. This rational number will recur. This is going to go and fall into the recurring category. Means, now if I want to draw a conclusion, rational numbers whose denominators are a power of 2 or a power of 5 or a combination of 2 and 5 only, there shouldn't be anything extra. Only 2s and only 5s. 4 times 2, 1 times 5 allowed. 3 times 2, 2 times 5 allowed. Or 10 times 5, 1 times 2 also allowed. But no other extra, nobody is allowed. Bahyacha koni chalnar nahi. Fakta 2 ani 5. Only 2 and 5 are allowed. No one else is allowed into that. And that is going to give me terminating. So I am repeating the statement. Very, very important. The conclusion statement, that the decimal expansions will terminate only and only. Only and only if the denominator is a power of 2 or a power of 5 or a power of 10. Similarly, if now you want to check the recurring ones or other denominators apart from this, means what? 11 upon 3. Okay, 2 is there, 4 is there, 5 is there, 3 is not there, 6, 11 upon 6, 11 upon 7, 11 upon 9. All of these will give us a recurring. Why? Because the denominator is not a power of 2, not a power of 5. Now, 11 upon 11, if you ask me, will give me 1, which is a terminating 1. But this is not a rational number. Why? Because while proving irrational numbers, I had told you one very important point, that the irrational numbers must be in their, the rational numbers must be in their lowest form. Means they should not have any common factor. See, this 11 and 11 are having a common factor 11. We do not want any common factor. All these are co-prime integers. Then only it becomes a rational number. Or else 11 upon 11 is actually what? Equivalent of 1 upon 1. Okay. So this will be not be considered. So this is very, very important point. That is why I had taken 11. Now I am telling you why we have taken 11 as the numerator. Because generally 11 is co-prime with all other integers. So it becomes easy when we take 11 as a numerator. Correct? So if the denominator is power of 2 or a power of 5 or a combination of 2 and 5 only, expansion terminates. If it is not a power of 2 or not a power of 5, the expansion will recur. So this is how the rational numbers will have either terminating or recurring decimal expansions. So the last part, what we are going to see is number of decimal places after which the expansion terminates. Now, when will the expansion terminate? Only in the case of rational numbers. And which expansions terminate? We know that whose denominators are a power of 2 or a power of 5 or a combination of 2 and 5 only. Let me check here. 11 upon 10. I have found out the answers for you. You can do it. You can calculate it and see. But see what? 11 upon 10. What was actually 10? 10 was nothing but 10 raised to 1. Means what? 2 into 5. 2 raised to 1 and 5 raised to 1. Correct? Answer terminated after 1. After decimal point, how many places are there? Only 1. The final answer was 1.1. Only 1 decimal place. Why? The power of 10 was 1. Or power of 2 and 5 was 1 and 1 each. It was 11 upon 100. Actually, what does 100 mean? This was 11. This was 11. Answer was 1.1. What does this mean? 11 upon 10 square. And 10 square means what, children? See, it's very important to understand. 2 square into 5 square. Power was 2. Hence, we got 2 decimals. See, the power was 2. We got 2 decimal places. Power was 3. This was 11 upon 10 cube. So, the answer you can see is 0.0113 decimal places. Okay. Or, in such cases, what is 40? You tell me what is 40? 40 was 2 cube into 5. It was 11 upon 2 cube into 5. And this was because there were 3. See, higher of the 2 now. Now we take higher. This is 5 raised to 1 and this is 2 raised to 3. What is higher? 3 or 1? 3 is higher. So if 3 is higher, after 3 decimal places, the expansion terminated. It did not terminate after 1. But it is not about depending upon number of zeros. 40 is there, but the power of 2 is 3. So decimal expansion terminates after 3 decimal places. What we are going to check over here is that we will divide 11 by 40 and we'll check whether it actually terminates after 3 decimal places. Okay, let me see what happens. So what we could see is that 40 could not divide 11. 40 zeros are 0. Comes down to 0 after decimal point. 42s are 80. 30 was remainder, comes to 0. 47s are 280. 20 was the remainder with a 0, 45 is 200. This division was possible. We could divide 11 by 40 easily to get the 3 decimal places. And I have told you the reason, because here it is 2 cube. But now, if we want to get the easier method, okay, see, because this is possible. What if I would have given you 11 divided by 2 cube into 5 raised to 7? Now what to do? See, it's a combination of 2 and 5. Definitely is going to terminate. Now how will you, and after how many places will it terminate now? Smaller is 3, greater is 7. It will terminate after 7 decimal places. And this number itself is going to be a very big number. See, 5 5s are 25. 125, 625, 3125, उसके भी आगे एक और 5 और एक और 5 मल्टीप्लाई करना है एंड देन मल्टीप्लाई बाय 8. सच अ बिग नंबर हैज टू डिवाइड 11. इट अ डिफिकल्ट जॉब, बट नाउ वी हैव अ सिंपल मेथड ओवर हियर. सी व्हाट वी कैन डू इज दैट आई विल टेल यू व्हाट. अंडरस्टैंड दिस केयरफुली. इट इज 11 अपॉन 40, दैट इज 11 अपॉन 2 क्यूब इनटू 5. एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंटली, most important, it should be in the reduced form. They shouldn't have anything common. First we'll check that. पहिल्यांदा हे बघायचं की ह्यात काय कॉमन आहे का. कॉमन असेल तर ते कॅन्सल करून घ्यायचंय. कॉमन नाहीये, देन गो फॉर दॅट. नाव 2 क्यूब इंटू 5 मीन्स 3 टाइम्स 2 बट ओनली 1 टाइम्स 5. सो हाऊ मेनी मोर 5 आय नीड? आय नीड 2 मोर 5, करेक्ट, टू मेक द इक्वल पॉवर. बिकॉज 2 क्यूब इंटू 5 क्यूब विल गिव्ह मी 10 क्यूब. 2 raised to 5 into 5 raised to 5, 10 raised to 5, and 10 raised to 5 means 5 decimal places, like that. So here 2 5s are less, so I'll multiply by 5 square here. We will multiply by 5 square here. Are we understanding? So let us see what happens. This becomes 11 into 25 upon 2 cube, 5 square into 5, 5 cube. And let me check. 11 5s are 55. 11 2s are 22 plus 5, 27. 275 upon 10 cube. What is that? That is 275 upon 1000, 10 cube. And 1000 means automatically 3 decimal places. Did you get the same answer? 0.275 and 0.275. Means what are we going to do? We are going to make the denominator as a power of 10 by multiplying by extra 5 or extra 2. Suppose here, now let us take this example in the similar fashion. See what it was. Here it is what? 11 upon 25. That means what? 11 upon 5 square. Power of 5, it is going to terminate. You know that. But here there is only 5 square. What do you need now? You need 2 square. You need 2 more 2s. So that 5 square and 2 square becomes 10 square. So what am I going to do? 11 upon 5 square into 2 square. So here also into 2 square. So very easy. So what does it become? 11 into 4. 5 square into 2 square. 10 square. 11 4s are 44 upon 100. Did you get 0.44? 0.44, because the power of 5 was 2, it terminated after 2 decimal places. So do we understand after how to determine after how many places does the decimal expansion terminate? So if I want to conclude, what I'll say is that depending upon the higher power of 2 or 5, but after bringing the number to the lowest form, suppose I had 21 upon say 700. First, what we'll do, we'll check whether the denominator is a power of only 2 and only 5. So what do I get? This becomes what? 7 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 5. See, 2 square into 5 square, 10 square is 100 into 7, 700. Now this is not only 2 and 5, because what you can see the denominator is 7 into 2 square into 5 square. So should I say it will not terminate? No, I have to check, because this 21, this 21 was nothing but 7 into 3. And this 7 and 7 is going to get cancelled. Means actually this number was nothing but 3
upon 2 square into 5 square. You could have done this. 7 threes are 700, 3 upon. Right? So the first important point what you can see on the screen is that first reduce, if possible, the given rational number. Next, check the denominator. If the denominator is only a power of 2 and 5, then very, very important, whichever has the higher power, after those many decimal places, the decimal expansion will terminate. Suppose I have 11 upon 2 cube into 5. After how many places it should terminate? 3, because 3 is higher. So it will terminate after 3 places. This is the answer. It will terminate after 3 places. You can find it out. How? Multiplying by 5 square, multiplying by 5 square. If asked, if they ask how many places, just comment how many places. If it was 2 cube into 5 raised to 5, then after how many places will it terminate? After 5, because now 5 is greater. So now it will terminate after 5 places. So it is very important to understand that depending upon the higher power, first, again I am repeating, first we will reduce the rational number to its lowest form by cancelling out the common factors. After reducing to the lowest form, we will check whether the denominator is a combination of only 2 and 5. And then, whichever is the higher power, after those many places, will the decimal expansion terminate. So that's all about our last part. Here we end with our first chapter, real numbers. Decimal expansions are either terminating and recurring, or neither terminating nor recurring. Non-terminating nor recurring were irrational numbers, leave apart. In the terminating ones also, the condition was denominator must be either a power of 2 or a power of 5 or a combination of 2 and 5 only. And if it is a combination of 2 and 5, after bringing in the reduced form, whichever is the highest power, after those many decimal places, the decimal expansion terminates. That's all from my side, children. You'll solve the exercise part. Do your homework. Thank you.